Well, first we're going to say hello to Kristen Stewart, who plays Bella Swan, a teenager in love with a century-old vampire, and in the new movie, The Twilight Saga, New Moon. Kristen, good morning.
Good morning, Kristen. Yeah. Good to see you.
And I know you're not feeling great this morning, so thank you. You've been running all over the place for this movie.
Yeah, we have. We've been everywhere.
For those who don't know the storyline, tell us about this installment, because now we have werewolves.
Yeah. Well, my best friend is a werewolf, and I come to find that about halfway through the movie after the really sort of perfect idea of love is shattered at the beginning of the movie. Edward leaves her, and...
Who's a vampire?
Yeah. Right. Yeah. So my best friend's a werewolf, and my boyfriend's a vampire.
You know how to pick them, don't you?
I know.
Wow.
And yeah. They don't get along.
Can I read some of the statistics about this series and these books here? And I know you know all these, but the first movie went on to make over $380 million. The books have sold over 70 million copies. Twilight DVD, number one movie of 2009, 8 million. I mean, it goes on and on. Yeah. Does this all register with you?
No, I mean, it does just in the way that I'm so used to doing movies that people don't see. And
we do a show like that every day.
Yeah. And these guys are running around with their shirts off all day. What's up with that? That's pretty good.
I know. They have good reasons not to be wearing shirts. They run at 108 degrees, and you know, when they phase, their clothes rip off. It's not just because they look
good.
All right.
Okay.
Yeah. Shirts off.
Yeah. But I mean, back to Matt's question. I mean, there's a sense of what has happened to your life. You must have a kind of sense. Oh, how old are you? You're about 19 years old. Yeah. And so this must feel like this amazing opportunity, this amazing but intense time. How are you sort of managing with all that intensity?
Well, I mean, luckily we've been so busy that we haven't really had a second to look up and see what it seems like it is on the outside. Yeah. It seems really crazy, like we live this life on TV, but it's so not true, you know? Like, we've made two movies this year. We made New Moon and Eclipse, and most of the cast worked in between, too. So, in a way, it's actually the coolest opportunity that an actor could be given, because we not only get to explore a character for more than 6 weeks, which is what I'm used to on, like, an independent movie, and it's also, I'm never going to be able to share it with so many people, share what I love with so many people. This is a once in a lifetime. I mean, like, we make movies for people, and so I'll never have this. I mean, they call it a phenomenon for a reason.
Yeah,
you know,
they're lining up to see this.
Yeah, I actually
just
saw them. They're all right there, and I didn't know that.
Wow. And very quickly, you were also, you say, working on other projects. So you're working on a project now about Joan Jett, and you've been talking to her for that. Does that put extra pressure on you at all when you actually know the character you're going to play?
Yeah, a lot. In a way, that Twilight is a unique experience, because you not only have the responsibility to yourself and the people you're working with, but all of those people outside,
right?
The fans and the book. But Joan is now such a close friend, and this was such a seminal part of her life. It was the most important thing in the world to her, and she changed rock and roll for women, straight up, in every way. And people don't know that it actually started with the band The Runaways, and she's amazing, and it's awesome.
Well, so are you. You're doing a great job.
Congratulations on everything.
Cool. What a dream.
Remind people that the Twilight Saga New Moon opens Friday, and tomorrow Kristen's co-star Robert Pattinson is dropping by.
I feel better.
Yeah, I feel better.
Get a rest a little bit.
Thank you so much.